maybe just another person. But to one person in this concert, you are the world. Happy Mother. On behalf of Indira National School, I welcome you all to this eagerly awaited concert. It is indeed a pleasure to have you here with us to applaud and encourage the students of Class 6. The students and the teachers have been striving tirelessly over the month to ensure that today's program is a grand success. The performance that you will see today will reveal to you another interesting facet of your child's personality, which you will cherish. Parents, we know you will be an enthusiastic audience. We know you will cheer the children as they perform. Looking forward to your appreciation. Wishing you all an enjoyable and memorable day. Now I call upon the students to begin the program with our school prayer.
Stretching over 5,000 years provides the most distinctive feature in the coexistence of unity and diversity.
Yes, India is said to be a synthesis of diverse social and cultural elements. It is a grand synthesis of cultures, religions and languages of the people belonging to different castes and communities.
Whether it's the gathering of the faithful bowing in prayer in the courtyard of a mosque,
or or the gathering of lamps that light up houses at Diwali.
The good cheers of Christmas or the brotherhood of Baisakhi.
The religions of India are celebrations of shared emotions that bring people together.
Come and let us have a glimpse of how people from different religions and the cultures of India unite in a common cause of brotherhood to make India an incredible India.
Music, dance and drama have been an integral aspect of our culture.
Music, dance, drama, folk theatre or puppetry. Our country India has all of it in abundance and that is what makes it an incredible India.
Today, we the students of Standard 6 are going to take you to a wonderful journey of music, dance and drama which is going to leave you absolutely spellbound.
The folklore and folktales have been an eternal part of Indian culture since ages. Indian folklore has a wide range of stories and legends which emerge from all walks of life. The interesting stories range from the remarkable Panchatantra to Hitopadesha, from Jataka to Akbar Birbal, Tenali Rama, Gopal Bhar and Mulla Nasruddin to name a few.
The folktales also maintain the fabric of the society. The folktales of India is a body of very expressive stories which include all the aspects of oral history. Legends, proverbs, jokes, popular beliefs all find an expression here.
And today, the first in a series is the story of Akbar and Birbal.
Akbar was the Mughal emperor of India. He himself was illiterate, but invited several learned people in his court. Among their people, 9 were very famous and were called the Navratna of his court.
Birbal was one of the Navratnas in Akbar's court. His duty in Akbar's court were mostly administrative and military, but he was a very close friend of Akbar too.
Akbar loved his wisdom, wit and subtle humor. Birbal's wisdom and honesty made him one of Akbar's most trusted courtiers.
Birbal had the ability to outwit and tease everyone from the smallest cheat to the emperor himself.
He also protected Akbar from the danger of arrogance and unflattered power. Most important, he made Akbar laugh.
Many courtiers were jealous of Birbal and often planned his downfall. Almost every day, Birbal had to prove his intelligence.
This skit will give you a glimpse about how Akbar tried to outwit Birbal. Akbar knows that there is no specific answer, but he asks Birbal a question to check his ability of answery and smartness. Scene 1, Darbar ka Drashya.
पर बैठकर जूते ठीक करने लगते हैं। यह देखकर सभी राहगीर आपस में उनके बारे में कानाफूसी करना शुरू कर देते हैं।
अरे बीरबल जी, क्या हुआ? आप यहाँ क्यों बैठे हुए हैं?
बीरबल उन्हें जवाब देना जरूरी नहीं समझते हैं।
बीरबल उन्हें देखकर मुस्कुराते हैं और अपनी किताब में कुछ लिखते हैं। फिर से जूते ठीक करने लगते हैं।
बीरबल, आज आप दरबार नहीं गए?
बीरबल फिर मुस्कुराकर कुछ लिखते हैं पर जवाब नहीं देते।
हाँ, बिल्कुल ठीक बात है।
इस तरह 6 दिन बीत जाते हैं। अनगिनत लोग बीरबल से वही एक प्रश्न पूछते हैं पर बीरबल किसी को कोई जवाब नहीं देते।
बीरबल की इस अजीब सी हरकत की खबर बादशाह अकबर तक पहुंच जाती है। बीरबल उन्हें भी कोई जवाब नहीं देते। अकबर झुंझला कर वहां से चले जाते हैं।
आठवां दिन सुबह का समय। आठवां दिन सुबह का समय। दरबारी आपस में बीरबल के बारे में बात करते हैं।
बीरबल को दरबार में पेश किया जाए।
बीरबल जहांपनाह को बड़ी सी अंधे व्यक्तियों के नामों की सूची पेश करते हैं।
राज्य में उपस्थित अन्य लोगों की सूची। राधेश्याम, कजरीबाई, मुहम्मद शेख, फातिमा बेगम।
क्या हुआ, आप लोग क्यों गए?
जापना वो
हमारा आदेश है, आगे बढ़िए।
जापना इस सूची का अगला नाम है जापना अकबर। जहांपनाह मेरी कथा माफ करें, पिछले 7 दिनों में उन सभी लोगों की तरह आपने भी मुझे जूते ठीक करते हुए देखा, परंतु फिर भी आपने मुझसे पूछा कि मैं क्या कर रहा हूँ, इसीलिए मैंने आपका नाम इन अंधे लोगों की सूची में डाल दिया। जहांपनाह कृपया क्रोधित न हो, बल्कि आपको तो मालूम है कि बीरबल आपका अपमान नहीं कर रहे बल्कि आपको सच्चाई बता रहे हैं। जहांपनाह बीरबल जी का अर्थ है कि जब लोगों के पास आगे रहते हुए भी चीजों को देखकर अनदेखा करते हैं तो अंधों की गिनती करने का कोई मतलब नहीं है।
मंत्री जी, मैं आपका और बीरबल जी का मतलब समझ गया। बीरबल जी, मैं आपका शुक्रगुजार हूँ, आपने मेरी आंखें खोली।
बीरबल ने अपनी बुद्धि से सारे दरबारी को चकित कर दिया, मगर इस पर भी सारे दरबारी संतुष्ट नहीं थे और बीरबल की परीक्षा लेने का कोई अवसर नहीं छोड़ते थे।
Culture and tradition. Diversity in all spheres makes the Indian culture quite unique. Folk and tribal dances are product of different socio-economics and tradition. They have added richness to the Indian culture. Since all festivals are accompanied by celebration, folk dances have become an integral part of our society.
The Bihu dance is a folk dance from the Indian state of Assam related to the Bihu festival. This joyous dance is performed by young men and women and is characterized by brisk dance steps and rapid hand movements. This dance shows the joy on the arrival of spring season. A traditional Bihu performance is eye-catching and is worth cherishing as it recites the happiness and heritage of Assamese people. Of Nadia in the 18th century.
You know, Gopal used to give joy to others by laughter and ridicule.
Yes, I also know that the king considered Gopal as a Navratna of his kingdom, and his statue can still be seen in the palace of Raja Krishnachandra and in Gurni Krishnanagar town. Gopal was a very intelligent person.
Let me take you into the world of Gopal Bhar, which is filled with his words of wisdom, laughter, and joy.
One summer night, Gopal Bhar was sleeping outside his hut.
His neighbors were simple village folk, love to daydream.
They were outside the hut busy talking. Let us watch what they're daydreaming about today.
I love to drink milk. I decided to buy a cow so that I can drink as much as I want.
That would be very nice. I also like cows. They are very cute. But we do not have money.
I know. We do not have sufficient savings. But that should not be a problem. We will start saving from now onwards. A normal cow will cost us about rupees 10,000. In our present condition, we would be able to save rupees 100 per month and we'll be able to buy the cow within 10 years from now or so. I will buy the cow from the weekly market.
No, no. We will not buy the cow from the weekly market. We will buy a cow from the cattle farm. I have seen the cows there. They are big and healthy.
Oh, that's great. Let us name the cow Kanu. What do you think? Do you like this name?
Oh, it's very nice.
I should start building a shed for Kamli as soon as possible. I need to take good care of my cow.
Even I should go to the market and buy some pots so that I can store all the milk that we are going to get in those pots. It's already late. Let's go to sleep.
As usual, Gopal Bhar is found sleeping outside his hut.
The husband had a hard day in the field and had come back home exhausted.
You must be very tired. Have a glass of water.
Thank you. Where did you get all the pots from?
Look, I bought these pots from the market. In this pot, I will keep all the milk that we will get. And you know, in this pot, I will keep the butter that I will be churning out from the milk. Imagine how much butter we will get from that milk.
Yes, I know a lot. But tell me, what will you keep in the other pots?
In this pot, I will keep all the buttermilk that we will get while making the butter. And you know, I'll give the delicious ghee that I'll make from the butter in this pot.
That sounds amazing. I'll be so happy that we're going to get so many things from a single cow.
See, I know how to take care of the cow. I will give her a good bath daily and I am also going to feed her with fresh green grass.
I think we're going to get lots of milk twice a day. I'll myself get a good fodder for her.
Have you thought, what are we going to do with all the milk and ghee that we get? I think we should sell the extra milk and ghee.
Aha! That sounds nice. But tell me, what's that pot for?
Look, darling, what are we going to do with all that extra milk? I was thinking that I will carry some extra milk to my dear little sister's house. I think you won't mind that.
What? What did you just say? How can you think of giving our milk to a sister? And that too, without my permission.
Why should I take your permission? I save money for buying Kamli.
And where did you get all the money from? Have you ever had even a rupee? Your savings are from the money I give to you.
What are you talking? I take care of all the household work and that's why you are able to earn. If you had done that, even I could have earned and maybe more than you.
What is this? What is this noise? Who is making this noise? It's so disturbing.
Look, Gopalda, what she said.
What happened? Why are you fighting?
She wants to send our cow's milk to her sister.
Milk of your cow? But you don't have a cow.
We do not have it now. But yesterday, we planned to start saving and buy a cow. Maybe in 10 years from now.
Today, I even got pots for milk and butter that will be required then.
See, everything is planned very well. But can you imagine that she wants to send our cow's milk to her sister? The same sister who never visited heaven she was in. Now you tell me, why should not plan it? Oh! Ow!
Stop!
Stop! Gopada, what happened? Why are you hitting me? Have I said something wrong?
You have not said anything wrong. But now I know who has eaten all the plants in my garden. It is your cow. All the hard work I have done in my garden. How careless you are.
But you don't have any garden.
You are right. I do not have any now. But I dream to have one 10 years from now.
10 years from now?
If you two can fight with each other for the distribution of milk of your cow, which you will buy in 10 years from now, why can't I punish you for the misdeed of the same cow?
Gopala, please forgive us. We understood our mistake. Please do not punish him anymore.
Yes, Gopala, we were daydreaming. We promise you that we will never daydream again.
Kolattam is the name of an alluring and charming dance practiced by the young girls and ladies of Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu and other southern states of India. This dance is performed by women with two sticks held in each hand beaten to make a rhythmic sound. This dance is a combination of rhythmic movements, music and songs.
Tenali was known for his wit and humor.
He is also one of the Ashtadigajas, or the eight poets at the court of Raja Krishnadevaraya, the emperor of Vijayanagar.
Let us take you to the world of Tenali Raman. Tenali Raman through the medium of mundane, everyday plots in his stories talk significantly about the deeper and subtle things which are essential for all of us to incorporate in life. True wisdom reflects in his action and words.
A sentry standing in front of the main entrance.
He is a generous man. He will give me gift.
You cannot enter the palace without permission.
I have come from a far off place. Please allow me to enter the palace. I am hoping that the generous king will give me gift.
You may get gift from the king, but what do I get?
I am a poor man. I have nothing to offer you. Please let me go.
You may have nothing now, but you are expecting to have something from the king.
Whatever the king gives me, I'll share it with you. Please let me go.
Half of it. Whatever gift the king will give you, you must give me half of it.
Okay, half of it. Now please let me go.
Okay, go ahead.
Nali walks to the gate. Another sentry is standing there.
Hey, where are you going? I'll go to the palace and meet the king.
How dare you try entering the palace? I will beat you if you take one more step.
I have come from a far off place. Please allow me to enter the palace. I am hoping that the generous king will give me gifts. Whatever the king gives me, I'll give you half of it. Please let me go.
Okay, go ahead.
There is a Raj Darbar in the middle of the stage, and the king is sitting with ministers.
Long live the king! Long live the king!
Who are you and what are you doing here?
How dare you come here? What are you doing here? He must be given 50 lashes.
Stand straight. How dare you enter the Darbar without permission?
I am grateful to your generous gift, my lord. Please allow me to share it with two of my friends.
So, you're not alone? Where are your friends?
The sentry at the entrance of this hall and the other at the main entrance allowed me in when I promised them that whatever I get from you, I'll give them half of it.
In that gift, I will double the gift. Give 50 lashes to each of those guards and bring them to me.
Yes, sir.
You wait here until your friends return.
Yes, sir.
The sound of flashing is followed by the painful voices of the two sentries. They are in a bad shape, dragged by the guards in the Darbar hall at the king's feet.
Here are the culprits, Your Honor.
Forgive us, Your Honor.
We will never do it again.
I forgive you this time. You have tempted my honest guard with bribe, and I give severe punishment to bribe givers. Get up. Cut off his head with a single stroke of your sword. Any last wish?
I have one request. My only desire is to die with the name of Kalima on my lips.
Granted. You wait until his prayer is over.
Be ready with your swords, Janav. Strike the moment I cry, Jai Kalima.
The guards unleashed their swords, ready for the go. Raman prayed silently with his eyes closed for a minute. Then he shouted,
Jai Kalima!
You can't fool us this time.
Get ready to die, now!
You cannot kill me now. The king's order was to cut off my head with one stroke of your sword, which you have already used.
For the second strike, you need the king's permission. Your Majesty, I have honored your order without any fuss. And now, beg your pardon. Please forgive me.
You seem to be clever. You have fooled them and managed to survive. I will let you go this time, but only on one condition. Never show me your face again.
Tenali slowly walked through the gates.
Continue, Shakti.
So you saw how Tenali Raman outsmarted the guards and outwitted the king. Let us share some facts about Tenali.
It's always a test of wits between Tenali Raman on the one side and the king, courtiers and head priest on the other side, and he's always a winner.
It is believed that Tenali Raman protected Vijayanagar from the Delhi Sultanate by his time limit and strategy.
Tenali is compared to Birbal of Akbar's court in wit. Its Kavya Padanga Mahatyam is one of the five great kavyas in Telugu literature.
Now let us move to the next kit and see how Tenali with sarcasm in his wit is able to puncture the shields of proudness the others have.
The king is sitting in the Darbar hall with his team of ministers and a big wrestler standing in front of him.
Maharaj, I'm Mahavir from Agar. I'm going around the world to see if I can find a man stronger than me. I challenge all the wrestlers of Vijayanagar to face me.
Welcome to Vijayanagar. You came from Agar. It's a long way. You must be tired. Please take some rest. One Vijayanagar wrestler will face you on the coming Sunday. Take him to a guest house and see that he's comfortable.
That you may ask them to fight with Mahavi.
Oh, what will happen now? Who will save our prestige? Raja has already fixed the date, and if nobody is there for the face off on that day, it will ruin the image of Vijayanagar.
We cannot let that happen. Please announce that we will give huge amount of gold to anybody who is ready for the face off.
Two guards enter the stage with drums beating.
Attention, attention!
The king has announced a huge amount of gold to anybody who is ready for the face of the renowned wrestler Mahavira from Magal.
3 days have passed since we made the announcement. Have we got anyone to fight with Mahavir?
No, Your Majesty. He's so huge. I don't think anyone can grapple with him. In his hands, all will be like chickens.
Is there no one who can save the honor of Vijayanagar?
Tenali appears with his face covered with a black pot.
Who are you? What's this nonsense?
Maharaj.
It's me, Raman.
Had I not wanted to not show your face again?
Maharaj, I am not showing my face to you. I have covered it.
All right. What brought me to the court?
I want to take on this wrestler from Agar.
Oh, at least now we have someone. Aren't you afraid of him? He's a killer.
I believe that I can beat him.
Okay, then we'll meet tomorrow.
Attention. There's a face-off between Mahavir, the wrestler from Magath, and Tenali Raman. Attention. There's a face-off between Mahavir, the wrestler from Magath, and Tenali Raman.
Are you both ready for the face-off?
Of course, Maharaj, and I'll finish it off at once.
Me too, Your Majesty. Maharaj, I challenge my opponent to do all that with my eyes closed and with his eyes open.
Are you mad? You think that I will not be able to do something with my eyes open that you can do with your eyes closed? Go ahead, I accept your challenge.
Tenali calls the guards.
Guard!
He tells something into their ears. The guards go out and return immediately with a bucket full of sand and splash it on Raman's face. Then Tenali wipes it with a towel. He bows to the wrestler from Magath and says,
now your turn.
But
this is a bucket full of sand. If this goes in my eyes, I'll be blind forever.
As a wrestler, you should stick to the point we agreed. Either you let them splash all sand into the eyes with your eyes open or concede defeat.
No, I can't see defeat, Maharaj.
Maharaj hugs Tenali and everyone is overjoyed and starts celebrating. They carry Tenali on their shoulders. Kerala is the richest state of India when it comes to culture and tradition. It has a grand and elaborate culture which manifests itself in the form of rituals, art forms, festivals, dances, customs, food, clothes, etc. Classical dancers of Kerala hold a special mention as some of the dance forms are the oldest and most popular in the world. Some of its most popular dance forms are Kathakali, Theyyam, Thullai, Mohiniyattam, Kudiyallam and Kolottam. Our dancers have put together the steps of these different dance forms. Let's motivate them for the effort and performance.
Thank you.
The dancers forget the many hardships that they face in their occupation.
And a wise man. He is remembered for his funny stories and anecdotes. A Nasruddin story has subtle humor. The Nasruddin stories have touched culture around the world. They are told and retold endlessly. The Nasruddin stories have one thing in common. They make people laugh. Have you ever wondered from where such humor come from? Today, the students of grade 6 INS present three skits based on short stories on the mullah to indicate his intelligence.
Tailor shop with a hoarding, two tables and sewing machines on the tables. Three tailors are sitting with measuring tapes around their necks. All of them have a piece of cloth in their hands. One also has a needle and thread. All of them are working in the shop. Nasruddin enters the tailor shop with a piece of cloth.
Excuse me.
How can I help you?
Stitch me a nice shirt. There's a wedding coming up in my family and I need to look good.
God's willing. It will be ready in a week's time. But first, let me take care of your man.
Nasruddin could hardly wait for the week to pass. On the morning of the 7th day, he hurried to the tailor shop.
Where's the tailor?
No, Sahib is not there.
When my shirt will be ready?
Come back after 2 days.
Two days later. On Saturday.
Is it ready now?
God's willing.
Stop. Tell me, how long will it take if you leave God out of this?
These skits may be understood at many depths. There's humor, moral, and a little extra to make us more thoughtful.
Nasiruddin had a habit of making people laugh. Wherever he went, everyone liked him. But some did not like his opposing views. But whatever it is, many people still come to him in order to enjoy his jokes.
Nasiruddin was standing on the street. Many people gave him money, thinking that he's expecting something from them. People offered him a small and a large coin, but he always chose the smaller piece.
A kind man who knew Mulla saw this.
Nasiruddin, you should take the bigger coin. Then you'll have more money. And people will no longer be able to make a laughing stock of you.
That may be true. But if I always take the larger coin, people will stop offering me money to prove that I am more idiotic than them. Then I would have no money at all.
The man started to laugh and agreed with Nasiruddin's thoughtful humor and moral.
Come with me. Let us go to a party. I will prove the value of money to you. Today, one of my neighbors has invited me for a party. Come with me.
The man who was neatly dressed looked at Mulla, who was in the same old dress.
You did not change your clothes?
No problem. Let us go like this.
They both started to move towards the restaurant. On reaching the place, everybody started to look at Mulla like dirt. Mulla went to the dining room. The crowd was seeing the scene and made a laugh at Mulla for dressing up untidy.
Mulla, let's go!
Wait here. I will return within 5 minutes.
Mulla went home, changed into a new coat, came and sat in the same place.
Sir, do you want a bowl of soup?
Yes, please.
Mulla took the bowl of soup near his coat.
Pretty good. Please have this soup. Have it first. Food will be served now.
The crowd looked puzzled.
Mulla, what is this? Everybody is watching you.
Dear friend, food and other delicacies are not for the people. They are only for their costume and priceless valuables. You don't have any respect as a human being.
Sorry, sir, to talk with you like this.
The server felt ashamed of his behavior.
Lesson to all of us, and we all should remember what he has taught us today.
Mulla was a really intelligent and wise man, don't you think so?
And was performed by farmers of all caste and creed to celebrate the harvest season. Traditionally, a good harvest is celebrated by dancing and singing songs to the sound of the dhol drum. In Bhangra music, the dhol provides the bass, with dholak or tabla adding a decorative part.
endless diversity in India, starting from its physical features to fauna and flora, races, languages, customs, religion and traditions. India has been variously described as a mini world and the epitome of the world. The diversity in India is unique, but underneath this diversity lies the continuity of Indian civilization and social structure. That is what we, the children of INS, have tried to showcase today through our skits, songs and dances. Every region in India has its own unique feature, yet all live like one big happy family. Thank you.
Now we present the students who have worked backstage and helped us immensely to make this program a success. Students who work for PPT are Utkarsh, Abhiram, Laksh, Samya, Parth, Viraj, Dhruv, Abha, Ronak, Prakash, and Sahil. Students who helped us with the light arrangement on stage are Aditya, Chinmay, and Praveer. Students who helped in decoration are Alisha, Himanshu, Minat, and Harsh. Vatsal, Harshil, Lai, Dhruv S, Yukta, Praket and Adi. Special mention to Abhimanyu of Class 6 Beta who helped us to make the e-card.
Good morning, everyone. On behalf of the team INS, I, Mrs. Aditi Biswas, would like to propose the vote of thanks to each and everyone who has contributed towards the success of today's program. A salute and heartfelt thank you to all our wonderful parents who put in their best and all our wonderful students who put in their best and made this day look so beautiful with their attitude and cheerful smile. I extend my sincere thanks to all the parents for their excellent cooperation. We shall remember their contribution in allowing and encouraging their wards to participate in this program and making it a success. I express my sincere gratitude to the supporting staff who contributed their share to the success of today's program. I appreciate lighting, sound and music system provided by the staff of Dhruv Auditorium has richly enhanced the grandeur of the show. I thank them sincerely. I once again thank you everyone for their cooperation in making today's show a grand success.